Hey guys, welcome to Automobiles Encyclopedia. I'm Rishabh and I won't be visible in today's video, so don't be confused. Today I'm just going to narrate this video, and in today's video I'll be speaking about the top 6 reasons to buy the Maruti Suzuki's S-Cross. S-Cross appears like a regular hatchback or a crossover or a hatchback. I'm confused. But as compared to others, say the Hyundai's i20 Active or Fiat 7 Jura, it's actually longer and merely 15mm shorter than the Duster. It is as wide as the EcoSport and 60mm lesser than the Duster. Height-wise, the S-Cross is taller than the others in the same range, which can fit your regular family with 2 adults and 3 kids. S-Cross's front end looks like the SX4 sedan. The SX4 launched in the early years had those short chrome grills and well-integrated S logo as in the S-Cross. Then silver strips in the headlamps and chrome all over its side skirts, roof rails and the rear side plates also remembers us of the SX4. It has the security system like the anti-theft security system, so no need to worry about your valuables. Reverse parking camera, engine immobilizer, dual front airbags and seat belts for all occupants, along with pretensioners and force limiter at front. And I bet you will surely feel safe in the car. The S-Cross is fitted with a 1598cc motor with an ability of producing a peak power of 118bhp, which is pretty damn high for a crossover like that. And at 3750rpm, it produces 320Nm of torque, which is also great. And on the other hand, the 1.3L version pumps out 88.5bhp at 4000rpm. S-Cross is fitted with ventilated disc brakes in the front and solid ones in the rear. Now no need to worry about that slippery roads, people. Talking about the suspension, it has a MacPherson strut affixed on its front and a torsion beam in the rear. Its 1.3L variant gives a max mileage of 23.65 km/h on expressways and 18 to 19 km/h on city, which is pretty decent. And in the 1.6L variant, it gives a max mileage of 22.07 km/h on expressways and 17 km/h on city, instead of having that 118bhp motor under the hood. So overall, it's a good car with great features, great power, quite satisfying fuel economy and great dimensions. Hope you learned something new today. Please do like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.